Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Tournament. Today's game is between the Mercer Bears and the Duke Blue Devils. And, of course, the ever-so-popular tournament bracket, especially at this time of year. And there is the starting lineup for each team.
Fans are going to see a great matchup today. Those two at the center spot, they're capable of putting up some good numbers and taking this game over.
Let's check out how these teams are going to set the tempo, Raph.
Every game, you have to pick your areas of focus best, figure out what's going to help your team win, and you execute that.
The Blue Devils get possession, and away we go. And he's fouled. On defense, and he winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in and get in trouble.
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key for any successful program.
Gus, he's young, but he's been through his freshman year, and he's learned a lot. This is going to be another big season for him. Let's see how he does today.
Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Raph. The Bears set up four around one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
They work it around the perimeter. They're called for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Here's another solid junior, Bill.
You want leaders on your team. At least I did when I was coaching. Having a couple of upperclassmen will always be to your advantage.
Hits that one. Hits two at the charity stripe. The Blue Devils working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Fires. Shots off.
What a rebound. I own it.
Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson. And joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Rafter. And it's knocked away. Great block. Great hustle. Inside. Power jam. He can put up points and he can move the ball.
You know, this guy can move the basketball and create his own opportunities. Really a tough guard, Gus.
He can't get it to go. Nice rebound. Pushes it. In the lane. Shots off. Pulls down the board. Hood receives the pass. Second team foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Being a freshman can be intimidating, but the key is to find out different ways to contribute to the team. It doesn't always have to be scoring. If he can do the little things and play strong defense, he'll be helping out his team.
He gets it to go. Thomas handles the pass. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Dump it inside. The Watch out. Bam. On the left side. Lobs it. Turnover. They'll go the other way. Jefferson handles the feed. And a chance for a three-point play. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the ball.
But he always gets your hand reaching in. You get in trouble.
Can he cap the free throw to get a three-point play? He hits it. The Blue Devils seem like they want to take the defensive pressure to the next level.
Watch for some full-court pressure, Gus. I'm curious to see how the pressure will be handled.
He missed it. Pulls down the rebound. We're at the five-minute mark on the left side. And we'll head back down to the other end. They'll start from the baseline. The Blue Devils now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
A chance for two.
Great attack.
He misses it. No, not this time. Way out on the right wing. Shots up.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Blue Devils in their four-round-one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
On the outside. No.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
Cross court. We're at the 4 minute mark. 10 on the shot clock. Out on the left wing. Dials up a long-range shot, but he misses his target. Lobs it inside. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Turns it over. The Blue Devils in a hurry. Now we've got a turnover. Now looking to attack. Looking for a good shot. Draft, these two teams in the first half of this tournament game have shown that they definitely belong. It's obvious to me that neither one is ready to go home.
Both teams are competing well right now. The goal at this point in the game is to remain close. You don't want to fall too far behind. These teams are demonstrating that this one may go down to the wire. Attacking the tin.
Now that's taking it strong to the rim, isn't it?
That's a great take. Strong to the tin. That puts incredible pressure on the D when you go to the hoop like that.
On the outside. Heat check time from long range. Off that time. Out on the wing. Pull up jumper.
Big time dagger.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. The Blue Devils running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Inside. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. On the outside. Turnover. He'll want that one back. The Blue Devils motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
He looks for three. Got a man down low as he gets it out on the wing. Jump shot. And hits. How about him taking it to the cup, Bill?
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
Around a minute remaining. On the right side. In the lane.
How about that, Gus?
It's a call for the foul. Aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
A couple of free ones.
Chance to breathe.
Makes the shot. You've got to be prepared when you go up against this team, Raph. Their pressure can be relentless at times. They love to pressure you full court.
Well, you're right on top of that, Gus. They really like to force you into mistakes with their pressure.
Out on the right wing. Off the mark.
Transition.
On the left side. Call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just got to know when to back off.
With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
Makes it. He got them both. Shots off. Next, the road to the Final Four. Please stay tuned. And a look at our game summary will give you an idea of how these two teams are stacking up against one another so far. Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game. Bill, what's going through these young guys' minds now? Here they are. They've worked all season long just to get to the NCAA tournament, and we've got a half behind us and a half to go, and somebody's got to go.
I'll tell you what, momentum is so important right now. One of the goals for either team should be to get on a little run, get a bit of separation, and then force the opponent to make plays and come from behind to win.
On the right side. Fires. Shots off.
Give me that.
out on the wing. And he can't get the bounce.
Seen, reacting. How alert, Gus?
Hall receives the ball. He shoots from the corner.
Perfect.
Bill, they're running their offense through the high post.
Doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Parker with the ball. Up and in. Ha ha! Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
Six minutes left on the game clock.
Put a little English on it.
And answer. How about him taking it to the cup, Bill?
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
They work the perimeter. From the corner! Can't connect from the three-point line. Hall receives the pass. He puts up the tray. And it goes.
What a big-time shot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. 5 minutes left on the game clock. Fires. He missed it.
Oh, physical play.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the right side. Off the mark with the shot. He drains the bucket. On the left side. In the lane. Drains it. Way out on the right wing. Jump shot. No. Ah, he got it up and in. Four minutes left on the game clock. They work the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. He buries it from downtown. On the left side. Fires. No. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. He strokes it. He gets it to fall. That's a great drive to the basket.
With authority, Gus.
Bill, we had a great tournament game going on here in the first half. I don't know what happened here in the second half, but it's not even close in here.
God, this is a close one, Gus. I think the last few possessions are going to dictate who moves on or who goes home.
When he gets to the line, he knocks it down.
He bangs these looks, Gus. A good opportunity. Points on the board.
It's good. The Blue Devils set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
On the outside. Jump shot. Off the mark. Snatches it down. The Blue Devils and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, you just kill me.
Hager.
Call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive. You just gotta know when to back off.
Free throw tunnels are a good indicator of how aggressive a team is. The more aggressive, the better.
Well, Raph, this could go down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Gus. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Gus, you've got to love these tight ones. So much on the line here. One wrong move is all it takes. There's no room for error.
We are at the two-minute mark. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He throws up the shot. It won't fall. He lets it go, and he misses the shot. Out on the wing. Around a minute remaining. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Nails it from downtown. On the wing. Fires. Shots off. Rips it down. Looking for a good shot. Now it's all about clock management, Bill. Stopping the clock in hopes of getting the lead.
Trying to sneak their way back in. Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
Sideline inbound. And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
And why not?
Inbounds play on the baseline. foul, and that stops the clock again. Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
They'll throw it in from the side. And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. They'll throw this one in from the side. Foul, and that stops the clock again. The bonus situation.
Oh, does that help?
Makes the shot. Gets it. We've got a timeout. More CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball right after this. Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. He gets the shot to fall. And I think that's his disqualifying foul. And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. With the free one. Book it. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. Smith gets the ball. He shoots from the corner. Misses from long range. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Coach, when a team shoots this well from the line, aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
When a team shoots a high percentage from the line, it makes them that much harder to defend.
Moten handles the feed. That trap could spell trouble. As time runs out, can't get it to go. Bill, I think the better team won. It's heartbreaking for the other side, but that's the way it goes. Five and advance is the name of the game.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all of the little intangibles we consistently talk about. And that was the difference in this game.
That concludes our coverage on CBS Sports. For the Governor, Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson saying good night.